they forges in this video we discuss the plan for upcoming videos on the enemy system, how to clean up managed components, and lay the fundamentals for systems that support two types of enemies, moving and jumping. We will be set the enemies on a level scene, so the spawn position is determined directly. Okay, so let's dive in and see how to implement this. First of all, let's create new script called enemy manage component data. Inside it, we want to store three variables, public game object, transform, and animator. It will allow us to bypass ECS limitations with animations without using some third-party asset or some complex own system. In this case, let's derive from iCleanup component data, so our cleanup system will do the cleanup after entity destroy. We will also need to keep enemy visualization, so let's add new component data class. This time, let's derive from iComponent data. Here, add public game object field. Let's prepare some basic component data for our enemies, so moving enemy component data struct with field movement speed. Also, let's create component data for other enemy, so jumping enemy component data struct, and inside it, we can add jump force field. It will be helpful later. Also, I did a small mistake, so let's go back to the moving enemy component data and change class to struct. So finally, after creating all necessary component datas, we need to create enemy afferent class. It will have our enemy visualization game object, so serialize field and getter. Also, let's prepare enemy baker class with bake method. Here we want to get entity with transfer usage flags.none and add component object, enemy visualization component data, so we are able to handle manage type, so animations, via ECS. Pass afferent.enemy visualization to game object and rename game object to enemy visualization for clarify. Since we are at the fundamentals, let's create moving enemy afferent. In this case, we need a parameter to specify the speed. As before, let's create a baker. And in the bake method, after retrieving the entity, let's add a new component, moving enemy component data, and pass the parameter movement speed. Also, let's prepare jumping enemy afferent. It is exactly same process with only other types, jumping enemy component data, and variables, jump force. So I will do it in the fast forward. That's it. We can focus on the enemy visualization system, in which we will spawn enemy visualization and attach managed component data to have full control over animator. So let's create new eye system, enemy visualization system. Of course, we'd update in group type of simulation system group attribute. Then let's prepare on create, on update, and on destroy methods. Now it's time to add enemy entity query variable and assign it in the onCreate. Enemy entity query equals systemapi.queryBuilder with all enemy visualization component data, with non-enemy managed component data, and call build. Remember to add state.require for update enemy entity query. Okay, so let's handle spawn logic. Inside on update, let's create native array entity enemies equals to the enemy entity query dot to entity array with allocator dot temp. Now, for each enemy entity, we need to get component object, enemy visualization component data, and instantiate game object. Here we need to modify transform.position for spawn object, so systemapi.getComponent local transform entity.position. Last thing to do, let's add component object via state.entityManager, pass entity and new enemy manage component data with parameters game object, transform and get component animator. Okay, but what if we want to change level and destroy entity? It is a good question. We need to clean up our enemy manage component data, so I clean up component data manually. Let's create new iSystem, enemy manage cleanup system. Here, also create on create, on update and on destroy methods. Add new private entity query, enemy manage entity query variable. It will let us to determine if enemy entities are destroyed or not. Inside onCreate, let's write state.requireForUpdate and simulation entity command buffer system.singleton because we need to use ECB to propagate changes. Then let's assign to enemy managed entity query systemapi.queryBuilder with all enemy managed component data and with none local transfer because destroyed entity don't have transfer component. Of course, build and let's add require for update and pass query. Inside on update, let's cache enemies from entity query with allocator.temp. Then declare and assign entity command buffer, so write ECB equals get entity command buffer ref state. Let's go to player movement system and copy get entity command buffer method, paste it to our system and let's create a forage entity in enemies, then cache enemy managed component data via system API. Now we can write object.destroy and pass enemy managed component data.gameObject. At the end, remember to remove component via ECB. Let's create moving enemy AI system. It will only contain debug.logs. We'll focus on this system in the next video, but for now, it will allow us to check if enemy visualization system is working correctly. First of all, let's create basic methods and prepare entity query, enemy entity query. In the onCreate method, assign query with all enemy managed component data and with all moving enemy component data. Don't forget to add state.requireForUpdate enemy entity query. Inside the onUpdate function, let's write debug.log moving enemy AI system, then cache enemies to the native array. Entity with allocator.temp. Let's create for each our entities and log entity.index. Next, let's retrieve enemy managed component data via state.entityManager.getComponentObject. Remember to pass entity. Then we can debug.log animator, game object, and transform to check if everything is working properly. That's it. Next, let's create jumping enemy AI system. We can copy moving enemy AI system code and paste it to the jumping enemy AI system. Let's change type in the query builder to the jumping enemy component data. Also change text in the debug.log. And that's enough to test if system is correctly operating. So it's time to go to the Unity. My graphic designer has prepared sprites and I have created animation clips and animator controllers. As you can see, I have idle and move animations for the moving enemy and idle and jump for the jumping enemy. Simple as that. First, let's create new directory in the prefabs, call it enemies. So let's prepare enemy visualization prefab. First of all, create empty game object and name it enemy visualization. Drag and drop it to the project tab. Then let's add sprite renderer and animator components. Also, let's change scale to half. I tested it before and scale 1 was so big for these enemies, they were really huge. Okay, now let's create prefab variants, moving enemy visualization and jumping enemy visualization. In the moving enemy visualization, change sprite to the moving enemy and animator to the moving enemy animator controller. In the jumping enemy visualization, set sprite to the jumping enemy and animator to the jumping enemy animator controller. Now it's time to create enemy prefab, so prepare empty game object, then drag and drop it to the prefabs folder. Inside this prefab, let's add three components. Enemy Afferine, Physics Body, and Physics Shape. In the physics shape, let's change the size and bevel radius to these values. Then let's change the collision filter settings. Set belongs to as enemy, so 5th index. We need to add new layer to the physics category tags. And collides with to player and ground. Also set mass to 10. Okay, let's create two prefab variants, moving enemy and jumping enemy. In the moving enemy, attach proper enemy visualization and add moving enemy afferent component. You can also set some parameter, let's say 2. In the jumping enemy, also attach proper enemy visualization and then add jumping enemy afferent with parameter jump force set to 10. Next thing to do, inside ground prefab, we need to add enemy layer in the physics shape, so enemy will not fall into void. Let's change collides with and add enemy layer here. Okay, let's open level 1 and position 2 enemies. It doesn't matter where I will place them for now, because I will change it in the next videos. The most important thing is to place both moving and jumping enemies to test our systems. Everything is ready to go, so let's press play and test if our enemies spawn at the right position and we get correct debug.logs. As you can see, everything works fine. Good job! I would like to invite you to support us on the Patreon, where you can get the exclusive code, all models, materials or code used in this series, and access to early available content. Link in the description. Thank you for your time. I'm glad you are with us and our community is growing. See you soon in the next video.